Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today I'm looking at an overview, a review of graphing equations. You've already done all these before. This is just a review of that as you kind of wind up your unit on graphing. If I want to graph an equation like this, negative x plus y equals 5, this is pretty much standard form. In standard form, we usually don't like to have a negative out front, but the x and the y are together. And so when I'm in this format, I have choices, but what I'm going to do is find the x and y intercept. 3 points would be great. 2 points is necessary. 3 is great. What are those intercepts? Well, if x is 0, I'll find the y intercept. And if y is 0, I will find the x intercept. And then I'm going to go ahead and say, well, what if x is 1? Just so I have a third point. If x is 0, I have negative 0. Do you agree that if x is 0, that x term is just going to fall out and I'm just going to be left with y equals 5? That's like the cover-up method, but I could plug in 0 and write down 0, but it's not going to make any difference. Y is going to be 5. Now, if y is 0 by the cover-up method, that's also going to go away, but I want to be a little more careful because if y is 0, I have negative x equals 5. And so if I divide both sides by negative 1, I find out that x is 5. Negative 5. Negative 5 divided by negative 1. Okay. Now what if x is 1? Well, if x is 1, I have negative 1 plus y equals 5. And if I add 1 to both sides, I get y equals 6. So there's my 3 points, my 3 ordered pairs. If x is 0, y is 5. If y is 0, x is negative 5. 5. And if x is 1, y is 6. If I've done this correctly, my 3 ordered pairs should fall in a line. That's why it's called a linear equation, because the graph of the solutions makes a line. All the points on this line are solutions to that equation. That's what the genius of Descartes was, to figure out a way to display all of the solutions, because there's an infinite number. We can't list them, but we can give a picture and say, hey, if it's a solution, it falls on this line. For instance, let's take this point. This is 1, 2, negative 3, 2. Well, if x was negative 3, we'd have negative negative 3 plus 2. Negative negative 3 is 3 plus 2 is 5. That's a solution to that equation, and so forth. Okay, what about these two types, x equals 2 and y equals negative 3? We've done a bunch of these, so I'm just going to go through this very quickly. If x equals 2, then x is always 2, regardless of what y is. So if x is 2, y could be 0, x is 2, y could be 1, x is 2, y could be negative 3. But when we have x equals a number, we say x equals k, like some constant number, then we're always going to get a vertical line at that number. So x equals 2 would look like that. What about y equals negative 3? Well, if y equals negative 3, then y is always negative 3. Could be x is 0, 1, 3, I don't know. It doesn't matter. X could be anything. If x is 0, y is negative 3. If x is 1, y is negative 3. If x is 3, y is negative 3. And in fact, y is always negative 3, and that leads us to a horizontal line at negative 3. So those two types of equations, when you graph them, have a specific either horizontal or vertical, depending on which is which. Don't try to memorize it, because people tend to memorize, oh, x is the horizontal one. It's actually the opposite when you're graphing that. Just graph them like I did, and you'll see what you get. Okay, then you have these types of equations, and these equations are what we call slope-intercept form. We know the slope, and we know the intercept. There's a nice shortcut to graphing, is that we didn't do that, and so I'm not going to do it now, but when you go into your future classes, you'll hear about shortcuts, graphing in slope-intercept form, or maybe you remember it from somewhere in your past, then don't throw away tools that were good for you. Keep them if you remember it. But when I have an equation in this format, I'm going to choose values for x because it'll be easy for me to plug it in. The first one that I choose is 0 because if x is 0, then that term would just fall away because 0 times anything makes that 0. So y is negative 3. That's the easiest one for me to find. Now, I don't want to deal with fractions, so the next one I'm going to choose is 3. Why would I choose 3? Because I know that if I multiply 2/3 times 3, those 3's are going to cancel, and that's going to leave 2 minus 3, or negative 1. That was a great choice because it saved me time and effort. The next one I'm going to choose, I could choose 6, or I could choose negative 3. If I choose negative 3, I get y equals 2/3 times negative 3 minus 3. Now, these 3's still cancel, but I have negative 2 minus 3, or negative 5. I am going quickly through the calculations, but the process should be something that you've seen and are familiar with. So if x is 0, y is negative 3. If x is 3, y is 1, nope, negative 1. And if x is negative 3, it's negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if I've done this correctly, as always, my 3 points should form a line. Thus, we call them linear equations. The solutions to my line form, to my equation form a line when graphed. Same process down here, but I just wanted to remind you that we saw before, if you have a positive slope, you have a line that rises from left to right. And if you have a negative, you should have a line that falls from left to right. And you should become familiar enough with that to say, does this equation look like this? Yes. You see our starting point was negative 3? That's our starting point right there, negative 3. And then we're rising by 2/3. Okay, what about this one then? What if x is 0? If x is 0, that term drops out and we get y equals 1. That's our starting point. We know that we're going to be starting at 1 on the y-axis. That's what that point number at the end always tells us, where we're going to be on the y-axis. Because I have a 2 down here, I'm going to choose 2. Those 2's will cancel, and I get negative 1 plus 1, which is 0. And then I'm going to choose negative 2. So I have negative 1/2 times negative 2 plus 1. Now the 2's cancel, but my 2 negatives also cancel each other out, and I get 1 plus 1, or 2. So be careful with your signs. I have the point 2, 0, 2 over, don't go up or down, and then negative 2, 2. And those 3 points form my line. For my equation, notice that when I had a negative slope, my equation was falling. When I had a positive slope, my equation was rising. So we saw 3 different types of graphing. We saw types of graphing where the x and y are together, and whenever I have that, I find the x-intercept and y-intercept. Third point is a nice check. We saw the exceptions when we just have x equals some number or y equals some number, and those gives us horizontal and vertical lines, depending on which one you have. And then we have the slope-intercept form of graphing. In this format, by the method that I'm showing you, I choose 3 values for x. The reason is because it's easier to plug in an x value and just simplify this side. But I certainly could choose values for y. It's just going to be more work to do that. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll talk to you next time.